Okay. My name's John, and I chose to do my speech on a memorable moment that I had at work. I work in healthcare and have a lot of experiences with patients that are pretty memorable, but one of them sticks out more than others. I work in the cardiac catheterization lab, which is a procedure you do. You put a large IV in a patient's femoral artery, and you insert catheters into the heart, and you inject contrasts into the coronary arteries, which are the arteries that supply the blood to the heart. And you can see if there's blockages in those arteries, because if people have blockages, it can reduce the blood flow to the heart muscle and can cause it to be infarcted, which is basically cause it to die and your heart function will be decreased. So we do things like that helping people. One day after I was done training, it was probably about 6 months or so after I had got off training, we got called in. We made a call for emergencies, and we got called in for an emergency for a guy who was having chest pain. So we went down to the emergency department, picked the gentleman up, and he was having like 5 out of 10 chest pain. It wasn't horrible, but he was newly diagnosed with congestive heart failure, which means his heart function is poor, so he had a lot of fluid backing up into his lungs and back into his legs and his stomach. So he was newly diagnosed with that. We took him down to the cath lab, we started the procedure, and he went into an unstable heart rhythm, which is there's many of them, but one of them is called ventricular fibrillation, where your heart kind of just quivers. It doesn't actually pump, so you don't get any blood flow out. And we had to start CPR on him. It's just basic protocol. You start CPR and then you administer medications to bring the blood pressure up. And after that, we had to defibrillate him, so you shock his heart, and hopefully it'll go back into the normal rhythm that he had, so he gets perfusion, because when you're in arrhythmias like that, you're not getting blood flow, so especially to your brain, your liver, your heart, your lungs, and you can also cause brain damage. After approximately 2 minutes, you can actually get brain damage if you don't restore the blood flow. So we defibrillated him, we got him back into a normal heart rate, and we continued the procedure, and he had a totally blocked artery to his heart, so we put in a stent, and he was doing great. I went back in and checked on him a couple days after that, and his family was there, and we just talked for a little bit, and he just say how grateful he was, and it's really nice to have a job where you get like such instant gratification, where the guy's in real trouble, and you can actually do something to help out. And just at the end of the procedure, you can see the difference. And that was one of my memorable moments that I had with him.